Hi, I'm Artemy Kolchinsky. In these tutorials, we'll talk about what machine learning is, examples of machine learning problems, and some of the reasons why it's become so prevalent in the news. Let's just jump in and talk about what machine learning is. First, you might be curious how it differs from another term you've heard, which is artificial intelligence. I would say that artificial intelligence is the general science of creating intelligent automated systems. This could be things like chess playing software, software for controlling robots or industrial processes, and many, many other examples. Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence, and it's particularly aimed at designing software which can automatically learn to perform intelligent things from usually data that's provided to it. And from this point of view, in some ways, it's actually very closely related to statistics, because statistics is also concerned about making inferences from data and using them to predict other things. Now, to get a kind of schematic idea of the difference between these two, we might consider two different artificial intelligence systems. One of them is what's called the traffic avoidance, the traffic collision avoidance system, TCAS, and is basically a system that was developed many decades ago to help planes avoid each other and avoid mid-air collisions. This is essentially a long list of if statements and conditions that says when to trigger alarms, when to tell one plane to go up and another plane to go down, and so on. And these are hard-coded rules that were designed to help avoid collisions. This is not a machine learning problem because it's essentially some hard-coded program. Now, an example of what I would say is a machine learning problem is the following. Given some data, make a statistical model of something like personal annual income depending on things like age, gender, years in school, geographical zip code, and so on. And use these, what would be called independent variables, to make a prediction about, let's say, how much money a person makes in a year. Now, if you've taken a statistics class, you might think that this is just could be solved with a simple linear regression. And it turns out that that's true. That's one way to approach the problem. And simple linear regression is a simple case of machine learning. It's using data to build a model that then can be used to make predictions about other things. If you want a more cinematic example of the difference between AI and machine learning, you can think of the computer in 2001 A Space Odyssey, HAL 9000, which was seemed like it was essentially programmed to carry out a single-minded task of the space mission, and that would be a classic AI example. Compare that to the computer in the 1980s classic War Games, which was trained to learn to play global thermonuclear war and then could learn to play things like tic-tac-toe, and that would be an example of a machine learning AI. Okay, moving on, I'm going to talk about two major areas of machine learning, supervised learning and unsupervised learning. In supervised learning, there's essentially a right answer to a question, and we train the algorithm by showing it what the right answers are. Examples of this might be the following. I give you an image, and I ask you to classify it as either cat or dog. There's clearly a right answer for most images. Or I give you an audio recording and I ask you to parse the text that was actually said in that audio recording. Or finally, I might give you some kind of stock market historical data and I ask you to predict what the stock market will be. Now, the stock market will reach a certain level, and so we can be right or wrong. In this tutorial, we'll mainly talk about supervised learning. However, you should also know about this other area of machine learning called unsupervised learning. And in unsupervised learning, there's no right answer per se, but what we wish to do is find meaningful patterns in the data. This might be something like take some very high dimensional data set and represent it in a low dimensional space. It might be something like take a data set and cluster it into groups. So that's another example you see on the screen where we visually can see that there's a scatter plot and there's some grouping there. What is the right grouping? Well, there might not be one right grouping, but we still would like to cluster things. It also includes things like outlier detection and anomaly detection, where it's not exactly clear what the right answer is, but it's still useful to have some kind of pattern finding algorithm. In addition to supervised learning and unsupervised learning, there's many, many other mixtures and variations and alternatives to these, such as transfer learning, semi-supervised learning, and so on. We won't have time to get into most of these, but you should know that the domain areas of machine learning are very large, but supervised learning is probably the one that's had the most successes recently, and it's the one we'll talk most about. Okay, so how does supervised learning actually work? In supervised learning, we're given what's called a training data set. I'm going to use the example of taking images and mapping them to a label, dog or cat, depending on what's shown in the image. Our training data set would then consist of a whole bunch of images, and for each of those, a label. Is this a dog or is this a cat? Now we take that training data set and we take what's called a statistical model, or generally some kind of machine learning model, and we take a learning algorithm. And we'll talk about what happens in this process when they're combined. But when they're combined, we say that we train the model, and the outcome of this is a trained model. Okay? So this trained model has learned something about the association between images and the label dog or cat. And once we've trained it, we can actually give this trained model an image it has never seen before, and it's going to make a prediction. Is this a dog or a cat? And if we've done a good job, then it should be right about its prediction. And we'll talk about that more later. Okay, so just one thing that's really important to remember is that we've talked about some examples, like a classic one, learning whether images are dogs or cats, but there's many, many, many problems in the world that can be seen as supervised learning problems. For example, playing a video game, automatically learning how to play a video game, is an example of a supervised learning problem. We can think of the supervised learning problem is learning a mapping from the current state of the video game screen to what should my next move be? Should it be left, right, jump, or fire, for example? And one way that such models are trained, and a term that you will hear, is reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning is a type of supervised learning in which essentially the algorithm performs many run-throughs through some kind of sequence of events, and at the end of these sequence of events it gets a positive or negative reward, and it actually changes how it runs through the sequence of events so as to maximize the reward it's getting. This will come up a little bit later in the context of Go, which we'll talk about in a later tutorial. Another example of a supervised learning problem is machine translation. So I might give you a sentence in English, and I might want your algorithm to learn how to translate this to a sentence in Spanish. Traditionally, this has been a very difficult task for supervised learning and machine learning algorithms, but as we'll also talk about later, there's been actually a great deal of success in this recently. And one thing you might hear in the context of machine translation and similar tasks is sequence learning. Sequence learning just means that the thing that you're mapping from or to is a long sequence of something. Like, for example, it could be a long sequence of words, as in language. And you'll also hear the terms recurrent neural networks and things like long short-term memory networks, LSTMs, in conjunction with sequence learning. So these recurrent neural networks are the reason that there's been a lot of advances in language translation recently, actually. Finally, the last example I'll talk about is something like a recommendation system. So we might want to take the set of songs that you've listened to on some kind of music listening app and now suggest a new song that we think you'll like based on what you've listened to. You probably are all familiar with these examples, and they actually can work surprisingly well in recommending things you actually end up liking. So that's another example of a supervised learning problem. Okay, so one of the last things I want you to remember and take away from this tutorial is that there's many, many algorithms for doing supervised learning. Here on the screen you see just a small subset of these. In recent times, you might have heard a lot about neural networks or deep learning, which are actually an example of neural networks. You should remember that neural networks are just one example of a machine learning algorithm among many others. They have, like the other algorithms, their strengths and weaknesses, but we'll also talk later about some of the reasons why they might be so prevalent recently. Now, in the next tutorial, I'll talk about a spatial or geometrical way to understand how machine learning actually does what it does.